Hello everyone, welcome to another video, and in this video I'll walk you through the latest feature which are added in Dawn 12.0.0 by Shopify. Yes, you heard it right, we have now Dawn 12.0.0 released on 31st of October 2023, and in this video I'll walk through every single feature which they added. I'm not gonna be discussing the bug fixes which they did, but one of the cool feature which they added is the color swatches, which you can now display on collection page. The other features are related to gradient, which are not much important, but the color swatch feature is a really cool feature which you should definitely add on your store, which will definitely look good and try and will get you more sales. So if you want to learn, stick to the video. Don't forget to subscribe the channel, comment on the video below, hit the bell icon so I can understand what more content you would like me to create. So without further ado, let's get into it. Okay guys, so as you can see my screen, they have added gradient option for multiple sections. Now let me go to the back end. So that's the Dawn 12.0.0 which I have installed. Now if I click on customize, and let's suppose go to the product page, and let's click on product information section here. You can see that we have this option to change the color scheme. Now I can apply the gradient here. And we can change this color scheme from our theme settings. So if I go to theme settings and then click on colors, then that's the option where I can select the color scheme and edit the color scheme. So for example, let's do that with the scheme 3. So that's the option to add the gradient color. So if I go to Dawn 11.0.0, which is the older version, we didn't have option to add gradient and product information or the cart page section, or if you go to the checkout page. So let's go to the Dawn 11.0.0. I already have that in my development store. So if I click here, you can see my current version is Dawn 11.0.0. And now if I click on customize and try to add the background color on product information section, we didn't have that option before. So let's go to the product page of Dawn 11.0.0, and then if I click on product information, you can see that I don't have the option to select the color palette here or the color schemes here. So that's the most important feature they added. I don't know what's most important with that. I mean, we could easily do that with CSS if most of my viewers are code savvy, and if not, you good news for you that you have the option to change the colored background scheme from customized settings. And that's the repeat thing. I mean, they just mentioned that they added the color scheme settings on image with text section and on product grid section, just like I showed you guys, product information section, cart drawer and cart page. So they mentioned it in the cart drawer, but I couldn't find that in the cart drawer. So if I go to my Dawn 12.0.0 and click on theme settings and go to cart here. So here it is. Here is the option for drawers. Now you can see I don't have any option to set up the color scheme here. Let's try to go to cart, and okay, here we have the option to change the color scheme. Now let's try to change the color scheme to 3 and let's see if that works in cart drawer, right? So click save, and refresh the page. Now let me try adding any of the product to cart. See, it's still not working. So it's not applying the color to the cart drawer. I don't know what's the reason. They mentioned that it will be affected on cart as well, on cart drawer, but it's not actually working. Now let's go to the second option, second heading, where they're saying about the changes which they did in Dawn 12.0.0. So if you're using search and discovery app, by the way, if you don't know what the search and discovery app, I have created a separate video for that. I'll put the link in the video description so you can use that app and try to change the stuff in the search option of Shopify and pretty other stuff with the filters and creating custom filters and stuff like that. I have created a separate video for that. I'll put the link in the video description so you guys can see. Currently, they have added OR and operator in that app. Now, let me explore with you guys where they added that. Okay, so let's go to the back end and navigate back to search and discovery app. And now click on filters. And now when I add a filter, so let's suppose add a tag filter. Here we have this logic where it says OR condition and condition. Now let me give you an example of that. So let's first add that with the AND condition and let's choose all the values. Click save. And now if I go back to my collection page, let's go to all product collection. And now you can see that the filters are added, which I selected from the search and discovery app. So that's the tag filter, which I added. These are the value which are showing up here. Now, if I select any of the value, now you can see, okay, so there's another one. Let's select that as well. Now it added the condition of AND. So if this product has these two tags, only then it's visible. So let's uncheck it and try to find a product with one single tag. So if I select this tag here, you can see that it's showing only one single product and grayed out all of the remaining filters. Now what that means is that it added the AND condition. So if we are looking for the product which has multiple tags, we can simply filter out those using AND condition. Now, if we select the OR condition on our search and discovery app and click save, and then go back to my collection page and then hit refresh. So I'm going to remove this one. Now, if I click on more filters and select any of the tag, you can see I have now option to select more tags. So that's the feature which they added in the search and discovery app for the logic of OR and AND for your filters. So guys, the next feature is adding color swatches on your collection page. That's the most interesting feature which they added in this update, where you can display color swatches on your collection filters. And I'm gonna show you how. Before adding the color swatches on your filter, you'll have to create meta object and then add the field of color in your meta object. So if I go to meta object in my Shopify store, so if I go to settings and then click on custom data, here I have meta object. And if I click on meta object creators, which I already created before, again, you can watch the video, the other video for meta object, which I created. I'll put the link in the video description. So here's the field in meta objects of creators, where I have name, bio, photo, website, and color. Now in color swatches of our collection page, we can filter out our products by photo swatch and color swatch. So the photo which we have in the entries of meta object and the color which we have in the entries of meta object, we can display those as swatches in our filter. Let me show you. So let's go to entries of that meta object. So for example, the one entry which I have by the name of Taylor Swift, really great singer, you should listen some song of it. Okay, so go to Taylor Swift and then here's the color which I have added. First, I created the field in the meta object, then choose the color. And in the photo, I already had the photo uploaded, right? And saved all of the entries with the photos and colors. Now what I'm gonna do, I'll go to search and discovery app and add this meta object as filter in my collection page. Okay, now let's go to search and discovery app. And then click on filters. And then click on add filter. And I'm gonna search for the creators, which is my meta object. Click on that. And now you can see that we have option to display swatch. And it's showing us the option. Now let's edit this, configure the display settings. And let's first display the colors. So remove the swatch override. Swatch override meaning that if you have the blank color value in color field, then it will automatically override it with the other supported swatch field which they have added. So there are two supported field for color swatches, image and color, right? So first just selected none and select our swatch field to be color. Now click on done and then click on save. My creator's object field is showing up as a filter, which you can see on my collection page. And now if I click on creators, you can see the filter are displaying as swatches. So if I select any one of them, you can see it's filtering out the product as per the color swatch. And alternatively, we can also display pictures in this color swatch. So let me change that and show you guys. So let's configure my swatch and then select photo and then hit done and save. Let's check it out. Okay, it's showing up now. Now you can see it's showing images rather than the color swatches which we selected. So that's the most coolest feature which they added in Dawn 12.0.0. In previous version, we had to code a lot in order to achieve the color swatches in our collections. Okay guys, that's it for the video. If you want me to create a separate video for how to add color swatches in your collection page in Dawn 12.0.0, let me know in the comments below and I'll create a separate video where I'll walk you through how to create meta objects and then add the color field, then display that color field as a swatch on your collection page. So don't forget to comment below. Until next video, have a great day.